other city in America values music the way New Orleans does. This is the birthplace of jazz, the mecca for gospel and R&B. Even our airport is named after the legendary Louis Armstrong. But the sounds of the brass bands and the second lines were drowned out and silenced by the unrelenting wind and rain of Hurricane Katrina. As the water receded and families picked up the pieces, one thing that many say helped keep them hopeful about the future was music. And for two musicians that are shaping the current sound of New Orleans, Hurricane Katrina was and will always be an influence.
People always mention that a good artist, a good musician, has to go through such pain and such sorrow.
For Robin Barnes, the self-proclaimed songbird of New Orleans, music is what got her through that pain and sorrow.
We moved around a lot, and we were just trying to find a home. And the only constant thing I had was Kermit Ruffin CD, Louis Armstrong CD. I remember I used to cry at least once a night and listen to When You Wish Upon a Star by Louis Armstrong. And I always felt like, at least I have some kind of home with me. And that's one thing I don't think people realize is, like, coming from a place like New Orleans, you can take that. You can take it with you. You can take it anywhere you are. And no matter how bad things get, it's still a part of you.
One man who has the sound of New Orleans pumping through his veins is Bo Dallas Jr., son of the legendary Big Chief of the Wild Magnolias, Bo Dallas. Now, he says he sees the change, but we still have work to do.
It still is building. You know, I think it never really got back to the fully stocked that it was. Because back before Katrina, you had events going on everywhere. And these events with musicians now is not really like what it used to be. You know, and what I mean by that, like I said earlier, a lot of musicians have never came back. So you still have, you know, you have your Bourbon Street shows, you have your Frenchmen. But I remember at one time you had second line bands playing on every corner, or you might have second line bands walking around in neighborhoods. But it's not like that no more because a lot of people just have not came back to it yet.
But the music, the soul of the city, is finding its way back slowly but surely.
New Orleans is music. So we had to bring the music back to New Orleans. We had to bring the traditions back to New Orleans. As far as Mardi Gras Indians, the Second Lines, the Baby Dolls, the Zulu, we had to bring all this stuff back because that's New Orleans. And a lot of people thought these traditions wasn't coming back, but they came back stronger than ever.
For this new generation of musicians, all eyes are on the future with their feet firmly planted in the past.
My goal, my motivation is to show the world that, you know what, you may be able to see the sorrow of New Orleans and what we've been through, but we're still here and we are still fighting, and that motivation, that happiness, that hope. And if there was never a hope, we wouldn't have come back. After Katrina, that's all I had. That's all my mom had. That's all my family and friends had. And you know what? We're here. That hope led us to where we want to be and where we're going to continue to be, which is happy, God willing healthy, and God willing tons and tons of music.
Now, 10 years later, those dark days still serve as an inspiration for those taking the stage and shaping the next 10 years of music and beyond. On your side, Charles Divins, WDSU News.